It is a marathon Monday, and we'll bring it to you right from the start here.
Check 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
There is something about the spirit of the city of Boston and the resolve of the survivors and the commitment of the institutions in the city to make sure that the city was taken care of.
I remember being very aware and very touched by how the city clearly came together and rallied together to capture these two criminals, but also to support themselves so much after the bombings. We came to Boston to tell a story which honors those who were affected, and we were humbled and very thankful for the way they opened up to us and became partners in ensuring the story was told in a very authentic way. We're very fortunate to have many members of the Boston community with us on set as consultants.
It's such a sensitive subject matter, and Boston is such a small place. Everybody knows somebody that was directly affected. Pete cares. He wants to tell the story of these heroes, and he's committed to getting it right.
He got it in an instant, just find the humanity in the story and treat it honestly. And that's why real people are in this movie.
Even if they're extras in the background in Boston PD outfits, he wanted real police to play them.
Commissioner Davis, Commissioner. The New York Post is reporting a 20-year-old Saudi national has been charged. Can you confirm?
And even some of the locations, like Sean Collier's house.
We're at Curtis Street in Somerville, where Sean lived. They did a couple scenes inside and outside.
They had pink walls. I went, we should paint these, don't you think? And he goes, no, I want it exactly the way it was. The other big one was, we called it the Henneberry House.
I had the opportunity to come and see the set of my house, and it's perfect.
And Mark Wahlberg, this is his city. He felt a deep obligation to make sure that the movie treated the city with respect.
The truth matters in a situation like this.
If we wanted to make a movie that involved all these folks, they needed to know that we were paying extraordinary attention to the facts.
He is so concerned about making sure everything's factual, and that's great for us.
We spent so much time with the survivor community, time with each of the families who lost a loved one.
There were a lot of heroes that day. There were a lot of heroes in the days immediately after, in uniform and out. Pete portrays that very well.
7716, control, I'll take it on my way home.
Jeff has been very, very helpful. He's available to be a real consultant on the movie.
They didn't fictionalize a lot of it. I don't want to see a lot of stuff in the movie that didn't happen. I think that kind of stuff belittles the real heroes of the bombing, which are the victims.
A sweet old man came in and gave that to me today.
We're all trying so hard to tell their story with as much sensitivity and respect, because it is something that we don't and will never understand. And I think they've been so incredibly generous and courageous to share that with us.
I was so impressed with his commitment to getting it right that I signed on to it.
This is one of the big reasons why I wanted to do it, just the spirit of Boston and to do right by the victims and the people who were hurt.